I am actually disappointed with the results of the 95th Academy Awards. But it's actually my first time filling out an Oscar ballot, and I think I forgot to take into consideration the biases and political agenda surrounding the Oscars. So I just picked my personal favorites, that's why I got only one out of four acting awards. And I know that there's so many snubs and surprises at the 95th Academy Awards, and we will get to that. But first, I am Matic, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Living life every day. For me personally, the biggest snub for this Oscars is Angela Bassett losing Best Supporting Actress to Jamie Lee Curtis. I'm going to give you a context. So since Angela Bassett is the clear front runner when she won the Golden Globe and the Critics' Choice, I think her disadvantage is when Carrie Condon took away the BAFTA and then Jamie Lee Curtis got the momentum for the Academy Awards. Now, in terms of influence and the political agendas and biases that I have told you before, I think Jamie Lee Curtis had the advantage of those things, especially her parents are Hollywood A-list celebrities from the past, and she has more connections, she has a great body of work. And as I have told you before, since these five nominees are the best of the best and voted by their peers, it seems that they did not really focused on which of these five has the best performance. I think they rely on the campaigns, they rely on not on the body of their work on that particular film, but her overall body of work from the way she started her career, which is through her parents. So I think the reason why Angela Bassett loss is because of those political agendas and biases surrounding the Academy Awards. But I am not, you know, I just realized as I have taken into consideration so many things after I watched the Oscars, I think Jamie Lee Curtis deserved the award. But if you look at it in an objective way, if you remove her role in Everything Ever All at Once, the film still works. Unlike Angela Bassett's role in Black Panther Wakanda Forever, when you remove her character, there's a void, and there's a void that you will definitely notice, and the plot of the film will definitely not work. So I guess, when in my own opinion and in my perspective, the Best Supporting Actress supports or has a major role in the leads of the film. So if you remove their characters, there's a tendency that the film will not work. So for me, Angela Bassett or even Stephanie Hsu or even Carrie Condon and Hong Chau in The Whale, their performances is spectacular and is essential in their respective films. Unlike Jamie Lee Curtis' role, if you remove her character, the film will continue, or the film will still works because of her non-essential connections with the characters, with the main characters. So to simplify it, her role didn't really give justice for even a best supporting actress nomination. That's why everyone was shocked when she got nominated for Best Supporting Actress. And if I'm challenging you, no one remember her name or the character's name that she portrayed on that film. Unlike even Dali De Leon in Triangle of Sadness, she played an impeccable part of the film. That's why I believe at that time when the nominations were announced that Dali De Leon wasn't nominated, I think Jamie Lee Curtis' spot was, I think it, Dali De Leon deserved that spot. But then again, I think, I hope that they will give Angela Bassett different roles, great roles for the upcoming years, so that she will be able to get her Oscar soon.